leave me a comment. Let me know what's on your mind. Tell me all about your Animal Crossing experiences too, because everybody's having a different experience. Anyway, good morning, Tanooki Town. It's actually not morning, it's 2:45 p.m. Because that second day, or not the second day, I guess the first full day, was took a little bit extra time, like a lot longer than I thought to put together. Like, the hype around Animal Crossing right now is insane, and I just want to, like, oh my god, Mom! My dear Jepson, how is your new life treating you? Are you eating well? Brushing your teeth? Washing behind your ears? Washing your underwear? Are you washing your underwear, Ash Ketchum? Oh dear, I'm all worked up. Here's a little something to help you out. Eat it or plant it. Eat it or plant it. Thanks for the advice, Mom. Congrats on your new home. Greetings from the Happy Home Academy. Our goal? We want to help make your home the best that it can be. Man, you can't even escape the Happy Home Academy here on a deserted island. Well, I don't know. They're giving me gifts, so I guess I can't be too happy, too upset. But I have to, I don't know, get some sort of perfect house score with them at some point. I don't know. I don't know what their deal is in this game. And I got a wooden low table. Sweet! I learned how to build the table right here in front of you. Dude, I'm like a learning genius. If you watch the video that I released, the last Animal Crossing video that I released, I caught a tarantula, and the tarantula was then sold later for a great deal of bells. And it was good because now I got bells. It was bad because then I realized, oh, Tom Nook also serves as the museum. So now I gotta find another tarantula. Tarantulas come after 8 p.m. Yeah, I was playing around last night and I caught a couple of them. Or I caught one. Actually, did I catch another one? I think I might have caught... No, I saw two. I didn't catch the first one because I didn't have a net at the time. In fact, actually, right now I don't have a net. I should probably go build one real fast. When can we join? When there's something to join. There's really not anything in my town right now, so I'm gonna, like, play around for a bit. Single player style. So, you see, since the number of homeowners is increasing, I agree that we need to build a shop. However, when it comes to building supplies, our customers' homes should take priority. I have every confidence that you'll find a way to handle this little puzzle. The two of you have been training under me for how many years now, hmm? This should be a piece of cake! Well, hello there, Jepson. Are you happy with your home? Is it meeting your expectations? Yeah, well, actually, I never went inside. I should have gone inside. I never actually looked inside my new house. But I'll go there in a second. Houses are so different from tents. Yeah. Yeah. Thanks for that observation, Nook. They truly are. And apples are apples. Oh, shoot, I got built-in storage, too. That's right! They have universal, like, the built-in universal storage in your house now. So you don't have to worry about having a... You don't have to worry about having a thing to put it in. Your stuff, your garbage. You don't have to worry about piling your garbage into your wardrobes. The HHA, as we call it, will evaluate your home on a regular basis and will send you a helpful advice. A singular helpful advice. Only one. You only get one. They even send rewards to members whose homes achieve high ratings. Their evaluations won't intrude on your day-to-day life, so there's no need to worry. Just enjoy the fun. Which brings you to your new home loan, which is 98,000 bells. Can I pay in miles, actually? Oh, I'm sorry. That was a special offer that only applied to the initial getaway package fees. I knew it was too easy. There had to be a catch somewhere, Nook. Payments can be made using the ABD feature in the next stop. Gotcha. Oh, I have a... Oh, I love surprises. Wait, what? What's that? Nook Miles ticket is a special travel voucher you can only get by redeeming Nook Miles. Oh, this is to go to the special islands. The random islands with all the supplies and the you know? I think I just boiled. That was the sound of me boiling just now. You can use one of these tickets to do some island hopping adventuring. Yes, yes, go anytime you want. Maybe you're looking to meet some new characters or gather materials for DIY projects. Your trip is yours to enjoy in the way you like. I've left your ticket at the counter in the airport, so use it whenever the travel mood strikes. Now then, go enjoy life in your freshly built home. Indeed. Indeed. Indubitably. Invariably. Tom Nook, thank you. Hey, look, there's a stone right there. I can make a heckin' axe now. You know what I can do with a heckin' axe, right? I can cut down some heckin' trees. You know what I can do with some heckin' trees? I can get some heckin' wood. You know what I can do with some heckin' wood? I can build all kinds of things. So we're gonna build all kinds of things. That's the plan. Calmly. Calm, cool, and collected. We're gonna build a slingshot. We're gonna build... Yeah, man. We're gonna do it. Can I make anything else? Oh, look at this. Log stakes. Okay. Wooden low table, tiki torch. Tiki torch. I can make a birdhouse. Before we go any further, I need to use the restroom. Hang on, one sec. By the way, this is what my town looks like if you were curious. I have the minimap turned off now because I decided that the minimap popping up constantly was actually more annoying. At least at this stage, considering I can't really do much until I got the axe and the shovel and stuff like that. Which I didn't get until now. So the plan is to stream it every Saturday morning at like 11 a.m. But I'm going to do other streams as well that are just impromptu. Just throughout the week. Sometimes I might just stream the game randomly. Timmy, what's up, buddy? Thanks, on the congrats, dude. Wait, what? Timmy's proposing! No, I'm taken, sorry. Sure, yeah. What's up, buddy? What do you need? What do you want me to do? On a new venture, building a new shop. Oh god. Yeah. See, I really want, like, a cool outfit. Like, I've been looking for a cool outfit. Do you have one that you can share? Maybe this shop will have a cool outfit one day. Okay. We'll need a lot of materials for a proper shop, and we will, of course, offer compensation for your efforts. Sure, if it's a job, I'll take it. Dude, I'm always looking for a way to make some extra buco bells on the side, you know what I'm saying? You know? My illegal weeds selling business is not as profitable as I would like. We'll need 30 pieces of each regular wood, hardwood and softwood, and 30 iron nuggets. Oh, I guess I can go to another island, too. That's something we can do today. Dude, there's so many things we can do! I'm taking my sweet time with it, though. I'm easing myself into it very slowly, because this is one of those games that I just want to go and relax, man. So I'm taking my time with it. It's going to take me some time to settle in, and, you know... do all the things that I need to do to kind of, like, because I know that a lot of people, like, played it all day yesterday, and so they have all kinds of cool things, so. I will, I'm just going to be kind of taking my time with it. I don't know. Relaxing, man. Hang on, let me give him these creatures real fast. I would like to sell them fur bells, but I'm not gonna. I'm gonna give them to you so that I can fill the museum as quickly as possible. I'm gonna need you Southern Hemisphere squad people to let me come to your town one day. Or a couple of days. Several times a year. At different times of the year. Thank you. Dude, I look like a heckin' nerd out here. I look like I should be wearing, like, big yellow Wellingtons and a raincoat. And, like, splashing in puddles. I want to play in this sandbox forever and a day, dude. Like, forever and, like, and 3 days. Times infinity. Ooh! I don't have a mother flippin'. I don't have a heckin' shovel, y'all. Yellow butterflies. Shouldn't all butterflies be yellow? I can't believe it's not butterfly. That's why. I'm not cool yet either, Josh. Yeah, I'm just taking my sweet time, man. I see all these people, like, building their towns up crazy already in a day. I'm like, Jesus, man. I don't have that much time or energy, thought power to put into it right now. Not while working on other projects. Here, I found a creature. Those people that cheated and time traveled? Oh. Oh, dope. You can cross-pollinate to get different colored flowers. I'm gonna have to remember that. I'm gonna have to make some, like, orange flowers, because I have yellow and red flowers, so, like, I'm gonna drop them down and cross-pollinate these bad boys. Oh yeah, who doesn't get excited about flower sex? I can get the slingshot now. I can get the slingshot. Which is good, because I did miss a present the other day, and it was really sad. I should build the old-fashioned wash tub and recreate the scene from The Witcher. Wait. Blathers! It's Blathers! Is that you? Oh, what splendid timing. Yes. Do you remember the venture we discussed? Well, it's come to fruition. I'm currently stationed on an island that we've decided to call Tanooki. Yes. The local fauna are as abundant as expected, just as I told you. Oh my god! Blathers! Blathers is coming to town! Blathers coming to town, yeah. I nailed it. Nook Miles Plus is bad. It's never ending, and I just keep going. Yes, Nick, become one with the game. Just melt into the game, Nick. Well, that is very exciting. Oh, but you'll have to excuse me. I'm with a customer right now. Oh my god, Blathers is coming to town. He sees you when you're sleeping. Because he's awake at night. Because he is an owl. And that's what they do, alright. you better watch out. You better not cry. Blathers watching you sleep at night. What you need. I'll do anything to get this museum here as fast as possible. Since you've done so much scouting and collecting already, would you be able to find a spot for Blathers? We need a good-sized space to really build out a world-class museum. So do keep that in mind.
This is exciting! It's all coming together! Yes, yes! Yes, yes!
Dude! Alright, I'm going. I'm going real fast. I also have to collect 10 fruits, so we're gonna do that too. Oh, but I need... Here's the thing, I'm not gonna place the tent yet because I need to be able to pole vault, y'all. I don't have a pole vault, and I can't make one. I don't have the DIY recipe. Timmy, do you got one? Do you have the recipe? Blathers gives it to you, so you're screwed right now. Can I move it later? Is it easy to move buildings later on in the game? Does anybody know? Because that's my concern right now, is whenever I place a building, I feel like it's going to be so permanent because I'm so used to past Animal Crossing games with how permanent everything was, despite how temporary everything was. You can move everything later except the resident services. All right. You know, I kind of feel like a good central location for the museum would be good. I feel like the museum should be at the center of everything here. Maybe we'll just keep it here, ultimately. Here, I'm just going to build it on top of this tree. Oh, that's actually kind of perfect. I like that. Dude, I'm down for this. Let me imagine it, though. It looks like he's ready to go out there and do some research out in the field. It's a field research tent. That's great. I love it. That's all I can say is that's great. I love it over and over again while playing this game. Seriously. So there we go. So that'll happen. I guess this will be here tomorrow, I'm assuming. So this is what I've done. This is what I did last night. Right now I have a focus. I have a focus. And my focus is... Well, my focus was... digging up fossils for Blathers and going and talking to Blathers. But Gulliver is on my beach, y'all. Gulliver, what's up, dude? Where you been? Wake up, man. Wake up. Dude, long time no see, bro. No, wake up. I'm serious.
Who's at the helm? Just give me 5 more minutes.
I don't know why he sounds like that. He's been on a rough, he's had a rough day.
The waves are...
Ready the pool noodles!
No, you walk the plank, Ahab! You think you're so smart.
Don't want to be Floatsome. Can I be Jetsome? Just sounds more rugged.
There he is! He's awake!
Do you have my pickled herring pizza?
I already tipped online, so wait, I don't see a pizza. Where am I? Who are you? Who am I? Okay, hang on. I know that one. I'm none Oliver than Gulliver, a seafaring seagull of the seven seas. Were you the one who kept nudging me just now? Well, I was trying to sleep peacefully on the beach. Well, thanks for the wake-up call. Those tasty hallucinations tend to sneak up on me. Wait, you just have hallucinations? You shouldn't be sailing, I don't think, then. Maybe that's his problem. Maybe you shouldn't be out sailing if you have frequent hallucinations. Can you find it in your heart to forgive this waterlogged bird brain? I'm reading your vacant expression as a yes. Whew. Guess I dozed off and tumbled overboard again. Yeah, okay, so this is a regular thing. You shouldn't be out sailing if you're just going to fall off the thing. Yeah, you're an endearing character. My crewmates love it when I slip over the bow. Wow, yeah, they're probably out there having a laugh right now on your ship. Don't worry, the fellas will be here to rescue me in no time. Got an ace up my wing, you see? You have a cell phone. What if it's broken because it's been in the water? Hopefully it's not... Hopefully it's waterproof. Is it IPF resistant? What's its resistance rating? Oh my gosh, my handy-dandy communicator is broken! Oh, well, maybe that's because you were in the ocean, where the salt is, and the salt is in the thing. Maybe you should have thought about that. It's all cracked and busted, looks like it's missing a few communicator parts, too. Wait, what? I have to wait for my crew to find me on their own. That could take a while. I've only got enough nautical huns to last for a couple of hours. You, yes, you! Will you be able to find my communicator parts? Wait, what? I have a quest. Really? Wow. I haven't gotten a reception this sweet and bubbly since I washed up an old coral cola. That's a hard word to say, but I get it. Coral cola. Just sounds like somebody throwing up, though. Coral cola! Just sounds like... But more muffled, like you listening to somebody throw up in the other room. See what I'm saying? Coral cola? Anyway. I'm just missing 5 parts. If you find them, I'll try to cram them back in here. I'm sure my crewmates are looking for me, so I'd better stay here and watch for the boat. I'll leave the searching to you. I believe in you, partner. I don't have much of a choice. I believe in you, even though I don't have much of a choice. Well, cool. Well, in addition to finding his communicator parts, why don't we also go looking for more fossils? Did he say specifically where the communicator parts might be? Yeah, buried in the sand somewhere. Yeah, dig up odd spots. Okay, so I'll look on the sand, but also I'm guessing that not all of them necessarily have to be on the sand. But maybe I'm wrong. Ooh, present. It's floating in. You see it? It comes from yonder. Goodies come from yonder. All right, present. You are mine. Attack! Attack! Well, hang on. Wait for it like 5 seconds here. Now attack! Frilly pants? Frilly pants! I got frilly pants. The sky gods have blessed me with the clothing from the heavens. Frilly pants! So, when he says odd spots on the beach, he means those things that I've been seeing all over town, where, like, the wind blows slightly on something in the sand? Yeah. Yeah, yeah, yeah. I got you. See, don't think I wasn't paying attention. I found a communicator part, y'all. Let's keep looking. So, wait, can you dig up more of these communicator parts, like... Or wait, oh, I wonder if there's other things on the beach to get. I wonder if there's other things on the beach to get. But first... Get over here, you nerds. Ha-ha! Oh, wait. I see a couple of spots. There's one here. Oh my god. I'm gonna be able to get all of them right now. Gulliver, I'm gonna get all of them. I saw another one over here somewhere. There it is. Aha! Oh my god. Alright. Hold on. Keep looking. Just look for the wind. The wind is helpful. Wait, I think I saw something. Right here. Nope. Hold on. I gotta do something very important. I have to fill in the holes. We have to make sure to fill in the holes. You know what would be really cool? Tides. They should add tides to Animal Crossing. What a dope idea. Like, the tide can go out, and when the tide goes out, you can find things littering, like, the part of the beach that's normally covered by the tide. Wouldn't that be a neat idea? Ooh, a bottle. Usually these have DIY recipes in them, I find. Like, they just come from somebody in another world. This is kind of cool, actually. Like, it gives a really good use to messages in the bottle. Like, you feel that excitement of, oh, I can learn something from somebody far away. To whoever fishes this out of the surf, I was messing around at the old tool bench, and I came up with this DIY idea. Thank you so much, Hopper, for the iron hanger stand. Sweet! I learned a DIY recipe. Hell yeah. From somebody at random. Also, there's a communicator right here. This is the last one. Nope, never mind. That's a clam. A manila clam. Manila is my favorite flavor of clam. I prefer chocolate. Wait, can we use this fishing bait? Wait a minute. What does bait do? Hold on. You can make bait? Well, we can learn all about more fishing bait and stuff on another day. I've got a lot of things to accomplish today, mainly getting fossils. But also, do I have all the communicator parts? He only needs 5, right? Gulliver, my dude, I got something for you. It's a gift. I did find them. Got them right here. Oh, that's them! Those are definitely my communicator parts. Come here, you troublemakers.
You know, Gulliver, you don't strike me as somebody who would be able to fix that phone. Just on its own.
The pieces are crammed back in there. Let's see if this thing can send a message.
It's not gonna work.
Ahoy there, crew. It's me, your brother from another brother from another rudder.
So listen, it happened again. Can you swing by to pick me up? Nah, it's not gonna work, dude. It's not gonna work. Sending my coordinates now. Gulliver, over and out. There, that should do it. Wait, what? It worked? You just crammed all those parts in there and that just worked? They were in the sand, dude. You were in the, oh, all right, you know what? I'm not gonna argue it. Gulliver is craftier than he seems. Cool, well, thank you so much, Gulliver. I guess you're thanking me, but you know what? We're thanking each other because that's the way that Animal Crossing works. You're just gonna pace back and forth until they get here? As long as my communicator works again, everything will be all right. Let's see here. No replies yet. Says they read my message. I bet they're just busy planning my return celebration. Or maybe somebody pushed you off, dude. Did you ever think about that? Maybe somebody's out to get you. Gulliver's travails? I see what they did there. Travails. I caught a bluegill. Do you think it calls me pink lung? No. No. Also, I want that pill bug. I want that pill bug. Yes, I caught a pill bug. That's a tough act to swallow. Now I'm imagining eating a pill bug. What is that? Oh god, I'm terrified. It's coming closer. There's a couple of them. I'm gonna go over there. Saw one. I saw one up here. There he is. There he is. There he is. There he is. Nope. Get him. Is this a yellow jacket? Or a bee? A honeybee? Oh my god, it is a honeybee. Sweet success. Oh my god, I got a honeybee. It's adorable. I love bees. I do love bees. Not the ones that sting me. The wasps are evil. Wasps are the devil bees, you know? Like if you had a devil and an angel on your shoulder, you know? If you were a bee and you were arguing with your conscience and you had a devil bee and an angel bee on one shoulder, the devil bee would be a wasp and the angel bee would be a honeybee. Actually, a bumblebee, really. Would be the angel bee. A honeybee is the bee that would have the devil bee and the angel bee on the shoulder and arguing with his conscience. Does any of what I said make sense? Okay, so I went in my storage and I grabbed out any of the fossils that I had stored away, and any of the bugs and fish that weren't dupes that I wanted to turn into blathers. And I've got a few more slots, so I'm gonna go around and just look for dig spots and a few more fossils, and then we'll head over and talk to Blathers. See what he's up to. I don't know why I'm picking up things that are in holes. Now I'm gonna have to go back to my storage. Hey Sylvia, check it out. I got a fossil. What, you're not impressed? You know who we haven't talked to in a bit? Sprocket. Oh look, and he's chilling out. Having a orange soda, my friend. Looking built, Zort. What's up? Hey, let's chat, man. Don't mind me, I'm just keeping the peace on Tanooki. I try to do a few patrol jogs every day. I think that Tanooki is already experiencing the AI takeover. And he's starting a movement! Blathers is a hoot! Get it? Cause he's an owl. Have you met him yet? I showed him a fossil and he just kept talking. He said it was a fossil from a super strong dinosaur. I didn't understand the rest, but wow, he knows a lot. I just had to capture this moment. Just my favorite villager and me sitting in the middle of the town. He's drinking an orange juice, enjoying the wonderful breeze. Oh, hold up. I got a glowy. So hold up. I have a question. So can you... I've heard that maybe if you bury the bells again back into these golden spots, you can grow a money tree. Is that correct? Am I correct in assuming this? Let me see what happens if I bury this again. Yes! Oh my god. Is it guaranteed to grow a money tree? Can I move it once it's grown? These are the questions that everyone should answer in the comments. Simultaneously. I can't wait to hear all of them be answered repeatedly over and over. I might not be able to do it unless I have a golden shovel. Yeah, this is the first time that I've explored this corner of the map. Man, these towns really are huge, huh? Like, I feel like I've just spent all my time in that one area. Oh, and there's a dock, too. Oh, I'm gonna come fishing here a lot, man. I want to set up a little, like, beach getaway right here in this corner at some point. Let me know if you have any ideas down in the comment section. So I was thinking, I think I probably have enough. Let's go talk to Blathers, shall we? So I've been told that Blathers gives you the vaulting pole, and I already have the vaulting pole, as you can clearly tell. I just put it away. Because I got it from a friend, and I figured it would help me get my town started a little bit. And they were right. Blathers, my boy, you're cramped up in this tiny little... Oh, I love it. He's got, like, a fish tank over here. And he's got... Oh, this is going to be great because then once he runs out of space in this tiny tent, which will be immediately, he's going to upgrade tomorrow. I imagine. We'll upgrade this. We'll upgrade your museum real fast, Blathers. Don't you worry. This will be the central point of the town is going to be this museum. I'm so ready for it. Here we go, Blathers. We're in it for the long haul.
Whew. Whew. A pleasure to meet you. My name is Blathers. I am exceedingly interested in the ecosystem of this island. Thus, I have come to conduct research, if you will. Ha! Ah, who? Could it be that you are Jepson, the personage who chose the location for this tent?
I am. That's me. Yeah, thanks for letting me know that you enjoy the space that I chose for you. I have... pull it at you basically in the direct center of the map.
Now, regarding my aforementioned research, truth be told, I am determined to open a museum and henceforth dwell on this island amongst you. So, should you discover a new type of insect or fish, be so kind as to bring it here. I plan to exhibit these creatures as well as those you gave to Tom Nook in the museum upon its completion. Though, I confess, there is one smallish problem regarding said museum. That is, I lack the number of exhibits needed to secure permission to open a museum proper. Empty display cases will not do. Display cases with something to display, that is another matter. Which is where you come in. What? allow me to explain. You see, it's not only insects and fish I plan to display in my esteemed institution, but fossils, too. Who? As it happens, there sits a substantial stretch of land beyond the river. I would bet my pin feathers this primitive plot is flush with fossils I require. But the river, you say? I can't just hop over it, you say? I can, because I went to my friend's town and she gave me the DIY recipe for the vaulting pole. So sorry to burst your bubble, but I've already been over there. If I am to open the museum, I must require more items to exhibit. 15 more, to be precise. I fervently hope you will donate your precious finds to the cause. Well, I'm pleased to announce, sir, that I've already spent the last day collecting all kinds of bugs, fish, and fossils just for you, dear friend.
Eek! A tarantula! The horror! The repugnance!
Good heavens, I must maintain my composure.
Any hoot? My sincerest thanks for your donation. And though bugs are the bane of my existence, rest assured that the wretched thing will get the best care of care here.
A bagworm? A centipede? An emperor butterfly?
Blech, the pill bug. The honeybee. So let's get into the fish. By the by, I wonder if you have anything else that could be donated. And if so, might I take it for you? Yes, I've got something. I've got lots of fossils, in fact. Now that we've donated all the fish. This is the most interesting part for me, because as a child, and as many children are, but as a child, I was very, very into dinosaurs. I loved dinosaurs, and to this day, continue to love dinosaurs, and I share my love of dinosaurs with many other adults who came from childhoods where they love dinosaurs. So, let's collect a bunch of dinosaurs! This is a fossil! Incredible, wonderful, remarkable! Yeah, and Blathers shares my love of fossils as well. So, let's go, dude.
But I digress. Back to the matter at Wing.
Because he doesn't have hands. I must assess your fabulous find. Let me see here. Indeed.
Hoo-hoo! Of course. It can be but one thing.
A brachiopelvis.
My feathers. Oh, what a fabulous fossil.
And would you believe it? We needed but one more item to complete the application to build the museum. This brachiopelvis could quite literally be the key that unlocks the doors to our institution. Thus, it is with great anticipation that I ask, will you donate this fossil? Of course I'm donating it! I'll add this to our collection with the utmost haste. I never thought I'd lay eyes upon such a well-preserved brachiopelvis.
Dear me, I might give you a short presentation on the topic. I'm quite knowledgeable, you know.
Yes, please, by all means. Again, this is my favorite aspect of it. Wonderful, tis fascinating stuff, I assure you.
Now, where to begin? Brachiosaurus, whose name means arm lizard, was one of the largest herbivore dinosaurs.
Due to its long front legs and elongated neck, it seems to have specialized in eating plants up high. Alas, in order to support its large size, it likely needed to eat more or less every waking hour. What a ferocious forager it must have been indeed.
And that is what I have to say about that.
Any hoot, I will gladly accept your generous donation. I only hope we can find what remains of this fossil and display it in its fully assembled form. Many thanks to you, and best of luck. This also applies to the fossil you've brought this time, but only a specialist such as myself can appraise a newly discovered fossil to determine its proper designation. From now on, do please bring me any fossil of unknown origins you find. Whether or not you choose to donate it is up to you. Either way, I shall gladly assess it. Ha! Huzzah! I love that word. Huzzah! We should say that more. Can I all get a collective huzzah in the chat, please? Thank you so much. Hooray! We have acquired the number of specimens required.
My feathers. I am at a loss for words.
I never would have imagined we could reach our donation goal. On this, my very first day on the island! The generosity that made this possible. The passion. I am humbled to be the spirit of Tanooki. Now we must submit our application to build a proper museum.
Oh my my. I must make haste and prepare for the museum opening. There's so much to do. Hootie hoo.
Thank you so much, Jepson. You're welcome. I've got more fossils for you, though.
Oh no, you can't accept more.
Oh no. Oh, wait, no, okay, wait, you can still assess the fossils. Dude. Okay, well, we'll quickly assess them all then. Here we go. All right, let's check out my fossils here. So, we got Diplotail. Dinosaur track, nice. T-Rex! 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 Oh, no, we also got a mammoth skull! Oh, my God, we got a mammoth skull, too. Okay, I'm gonna go put these in my storage right away so I don't, like, accidentally sell them or drop them or... I don't know, break them... Dude, I'm so excited. The museum is going to be a central aspect of Tanooki Town, which is why I quite literally put it in the center of town. So, it's going to be a very, very, very important structure here in Tanooki Town, and we're going to be visiting this a lot over the course of this series. So, be on the lookout for all that, guys. Thank you again for believing in this series and watching all the way through to the end of this. You're the real MVP. I appreciate your viewership more than anything else. And thank you so much again for watching. Thank you for supporting on patreon.com/Jepson. And I will see you in the next one.